What's going on YouTube, and welcome back to my channel. If you've been here before, thank you for returning. If you are new to the channel, make sure you hit that subscribe button and turn on those post notifications so you are notified every single time I drop a video and you don't miss not one video. Everybody in here, smash that like button, share this video, and drop a comment down below during the video, after the video, before the video, whatever you feel. Let me know what you think, let me know what you like about the video, let me know what you want to see next. You saw by the title and the thumbnail, we got a good one. So let's get straight into this groom. Also, make sure you guys are watching those ads and watching the video straight through and liking and commenting. It helps me with the algorithm and getting me back out there so other people can find my videos and enjoy them just like you guys. Okay guys, so this is Bo. He is a party poodle, a standard party poodle, and he is massive. He's probably the biggest poodle I've seen. I honestly thought he was a doodle, but the mom said he is a purebred poodle. His nose is not as narrow, but that could go into breeding and different things like that. But as you can see, Bo is in pretty bad shape. So the mom was so ashamed when she brought him in. And I try not to pass judgment on anybody because you never know what people are going through. Now, it's one thing if it's a one-off thing, but if you constantly bring your dog in and your dog looks like this and you say, well, you know, I just went away for a week and this is what happened. Well, we know that this didn't happen in a week because this is not a week's worth of matting and debris and dirt and everything built up into the dog. So we pretty much already know, but again, like I said, I try not to pass judgment on anybody whose dog comes in like this for the first time. Now, if your dog comes in like this 2-3 times, I'm gonna look at you a little sideways because at this point, there's no reason for your dog to look like this. But like I said, the woman was really, really remorseful. So I completely understand when things get in the way. Life happens to everybody. So you kind of got to cut people some slack sometimes. So Bo is matted, but he's not matted in the places where he looks matted. So the only places he was really pretty badly matted were on his feet. So like the tops of his feet. The issue with Bo had a lot of dirt built in. So his body wasn't matted and most of his legs weren't matted, but because of all the dirt and everything kind of just caked together, and it was too much dirt built up on him to pre-wash him like I usually would, as well as the tightness of the matting on his feet. So I didn't think it was beneficial to wash him first, so I decided to pre-shave him. And like I stated before, the only time you'll ever see me pre-shave a dog is if it's absolutely necessary. So for him, it was absolutely necessary because the wash would not have got him as clean as I would have liked him to get clean. And although I'll just let you guys watch the groom so you can see how clean he got after the bath and his finished product. But I will definitely say he looks like a completely different dog, like a completely different dog once he is done being groomed. And he got the much needed treatment that he deserved and wasn't getting. Now, in terms of why he looks like this, I'm not going to get too deep into the woman's personal business, which I'm not really going to go into her personal business, but you know, they had some things come up and life happens. Now, he has so many different issues going on with him, it's insane. So along with the matting, he also has really, really bad skin. So during the bath, I wash him in a medicated shampoo first just to kind of ease up on his skin issues, because just around his skin, he had a lot of red spots. He had yeast just everywhere in his ears. His ears are like the worst, which I actually took a video so you'll be able to see what his ears look like prior to me doing them, and then you'll see what his ears look like after me doing them. And when I say it's a drastic difference, it's such a drastic difference in what his ears look like, because I have a pretty strong stomach, but his ears, the smell of his ears, I almost threw up a couple times because of how strong his ear smell was. And it was so strong that it lit up the the salon. And in the back of the salon, like, you would have thought that a dog was sitting in some type of mildew or something, but it was his ears. And we think that maybe he's been outside and that's why he looks the way he does, because he had a lot of sticks in his fur and everything like that. And I think he's been outside because of how bad the smell of his ears are. So it's a lot with him. He's got a lot going on and he needed a lot of TLC, which he did get, and I definitely think he appreciated. So yeah, we think that he's been outside with the look of his coat and his skin and the amount of moisture that was under his fur. We definitely think he's been outside because they couldn't handle the smell of his ears, which I do not agree with keeping your pet outside because of the ears. But per the owner, they've taken him to the vet several times because he has chronic ear infections and nothing has come of it. The ear infections have not gone away. They've recommended him to go on a prescription diet to see if that would help his ears, and that has not touched his ears. It has not touched his skin. So they were kind of like up to their wits with the ear infections and just kind of like frustrated because they did not know what to do that would fix his ears. And me just getting a look at his ears, it was definitely allergies that's going on with him. So it can be food, it can be anything. So I recommended them to switch their dog food and try a different ear cleaner, which is what I use on him, a certain ear cleaner that has witch hazel in it, and it is in my description box if you guys are looking to get that. But that helped his ears tremendously. When I was done with them, they were oozing and everything, but they were already oozing before I started. So, and you can see on his ears that he had rocks. I mean, it was just rocks of wax just caked up on his ears, and it was just really bad. So I shaved around his ears and I flushed his ears with the ear cleaner that I have, put a little cotton ball up on top of his ears, massage the ear canal just to kind of work some of that debris out, and then I cleaned them out a little bit. When ears look that bad, you don't want to dig too deep into the ears because you don't want to irritate the ear even more. So you only want to just lightly do it and then let the ear cleaner do the rest. I also recommended that they do apple cider vinegar in his food just to kind of break down some of those hard metals in his body that's helping to contribute to the overgrowth of yeast in him. And I'm waiting for him to come back in just to kind of talk to him and see how that has helped. He was scheduled for an appointment, I want to say a couple days ago, but they did have to reschedule. So when he comes back in, I'll do just a quick little short video just as an update so you guys can see what he looks like. So for his groom, I am, like I said, going to be pre-shaving him. And I'm going to be switching the camera around so you can see, so just bear with me. I don't switch it around immediately, but I do switch it around while I'm pre-shaving him. Now for his final shave, just to kind of go in and finish up the rest of it, I did just have a stationary camera because for everything that I thought y'all wanted to see, I had already switched the camera around for y'all to see it. So the aftershave, the final cut, I wasn't able to move the camera around because I was in a crunch for time, so I had to get him done and get him out of there because he'd been there for a while already, because his bath alone took an hour just to make sure he got a proper bath, to make sure it was good and soothing on his skin and kind of helped his irritated skin. So for his pre-shave, I am going to be switching the camera around so you can see different angles, but the final cut is just going to be a stationary camera. So because of the condition of his coat and because of the matting on his feet, I am shaving him down in a 10 blade on his body. And what I find interesting about dogs like this, their top layer of the coat is always so dark and dirty. But once you get close to the skin, a lot of that fur is really clean, pure white, which is so crazy to me. But I guess that's a good thing because that kind of just lets you know that their skin is not doing too bad. His skin was not the best, but it's not as bad as, you know, I've seen before. So I'm doing his pre-clip in a 10 blade, and then I'm going to go through and wash him, let him soak and sit in some medicated shampoo just to soothe the skin, and then I do a little whitening conditioner, and then I'll spray something on him with a spray bottle that you will see. That is a leave-in medicated conditioner. It's a quick dry as well, helps them dry faster, but it also helps with their skin tremendously, so you'll see me do that.
Thank you.
So just real quick, I want to touch base on the fur on the floor in the salon, as well as in my last video, there was fur in the tub when I put my dog in the tub, and a lot of people were commenting, well, not a lot of people, but a few people commented and said that the salon is not clean. Let me just say, this is the cleanest salon that I have ever worked at. When I say the owner of the salon is constantly cleaning. If a dog pees on the floor, poops on the floor, she'll go behind it. She has a squirt bottle that has water and bleach in it, and she'll go behind it and she'll clean up the floor real good, dry real good, so the scent is no longer there. Also, when we are done with our dogs in the tub, washing them, blowing them out, we always go behind ourselves and clean up after what we've blown out. So in my last video, when I set my dog in the tub, there was another dog next to me in the other tub being worked on, being blown out. So the hair that was being blown out of his coat with the velocity dryer was falling into my tub. That happens. It is a dog grooming salon. So you cannot expect the salon to be spotless. A lot of you guys who watch grooming videos on YouTube watch people who have their own shops and they're in there by themselves. I don't have my own shop. I'm not in a shop by myself. I'm always in a shop with other people. So there is going to be hair on the floor at some point in time. There's going to be hair in another tub at some point in time. And in that video, you can see the dog that is in the opposite tub because I turned the camera and actually looked at the dog because I was amazed at how much hair was coming out of that dog. So, for people who are saying that the salon was not hygienic, it wasn't clean, it was messy, it wasn't. The salon is actually very clean. But we are busy and we're continuously grooming. Like, there's somebody grooming at the other station. You can see the yellow shoes in this video. There are two stations there and there's another station in front of me. So there's five of us. So there's always somebody grooming. But when the owner is not grooming, she is constantly sweeping. She's vacuuming up the hair. But we can't vacuum it while we're doing it because we're actually working on the dog. So once the dog is done, then we go around and clean up. So after him, I pulled him off the table, put him in a tub, and one of my coworkers actually went behind, cleaned up the hair for me, and washed my blades because of how dirty the dog was. The things that you don't see on the camera are things that happen behind the scenes, and just because you don't see it doesn't mean it's not happening. We don't post everything. A lot of the people that you watch don't post them sweeping up the hair because that's not what you guys want to see. You want to see us grooming dogs. So you're not going to see us go behind and sweep up the hair because you don't want to see that. All of you skip past that part. YouTube shows us all of that. So we understand where you're coming from, where it may look a certain way, but it's not that way. We do clean up after our dogs are done.
said, I'm out.
Thank you.
So now I'm going to be pulling him back out to the table to finish up the rough cut and make it a complete cut. So now I'm going to be going back over his body with the 10 blade just to clean up anything that roughed up during the blow drying in the bath. And once I get to his head, I'll explain what I did on his face.
Thank you.
So now I'm going to be working on his face, and because I did his body so short, I don't want to make his face too long. So you don't want the dog to look like a bobblehead. So because I did a 10 on his body, I'm going to be doing a 5 on his head and his cheeks, and then on his ears and his muzzle I take out and do a 1 guard comb. So that is a 1/2 inch on his ears and his muzzle, just so he can still have a little personality, so he's not completely shaved down, buzz cut all over. So I left him a little bit of fluffy ears and then a nice little round, cute, fluffy muzzle. All right, so we are coming up to the end of Beau's grooming, and we're going to do something a little bit different this time. First, we're going to take a look at a before video of his ears. So this is the same video as earlier, just a reminder of what his ears look like prior to me taking care of them, putting a little ear cleaner with some witch hazel in there. We're going to take a nice good look at his ears of what they look like before, and then this is what his ears look like after the treatment, after his grooming. They look 10 times better. Like I said, I was not able to get them as clean as I wanted to because I did not want to irritate them, but I told the mom to continue on the antibiotics that the vet gave her, and that should help clear up all the oozing. But I did explain to the mom everything. So now that we've looked at his ears, we are going to take a look at his before picture. This is what it looked like coming in, and if you guys can see it, he looks like he has a little heart on his side. And this is his after, a complete transformation. He looks so cute. He is much more comfortable with all that dirty hair off of him. He's going to grow back in nice and clean and be able to get a cute teddy bear haircut. And I hope you guys enjoyed this groom. Make sure you guys smash that like button, share this video, drop a comment down below, do all that fancy YouTube stuff. I love you guys. Train your dogs for grooming. Make sure you watch every video straight through. Watch those ads. Enjoy the videos. I'll catch you in the next one. Love you guys.